We've encouraged better cost sharing for people. So people across the country have very high deductibles. What we've done in Massachusetts is we've said, don't just give people very high cost sharing in general, but do what's called tiering it. That is say, look, for basic levels of care, for appropriate levels of care, you're not going to face very high costs. But if you want to go to the teaching hospital for the routine procedure, you're going to have to pay a lot for that. We mandate that insurance companies have to be able to tell people the price of any service, their cost sharing for any service, wherever they might receive it. So if your doctor says you need an MRI, you can go on the computer and go to your insurance company's website and figure out exactly your cost sharing at each place where they would do the MRI.
So that will provide comparison shopping.
So that's on the demand side. Have people have more skin in the game and give people the information so they can do real shopping.
More skin in the game meaning higher copays.
Higher copays. And everything we know is that people respond to copayments and they like to look for cheaper care. We've also pushed very strongly, extremely strongly, that insurance payments to doctors and hospitals and other care providers not be based on volumes, that is not be the more images you do, the more you get paid.
So-called fee for service.
So-called fee for service, but instead be value-based payments. So say, here's a person with coronary artery disease, pay a fixed amount for that person and let the medical professionals figure out how to treat that person, not with the incentive to do more and earn more, but with the incentive to figure out how to do what's right and keep them from using very expensive services.
But doesn't that provide an incentive or a prod to the provider to stint on services, stint on the X-ray I might otherwise get, say, or MRI?
What that's being coupled with is a very aggressive approach to measuring the quality. So you can say, okay, here's how you did with your cardiac patients, here's how you did with your hip replacement patients, here's how you did with your patients as a whole. So we know how well you're doing and we can see if there are areas where you're particularly stinting. We're blessed here in that our doctors and our healthcare providers are not the kinds who are sort of out to make a quick buck by saying, oh gee, what can I deny today? What they really want to do is get out of the runaround, which is, okay, money is tight, what do I need to do to earn more? Imaging pays well, let's ramp up the imaging.
And that's clearly what's been happening.
That's clearly what's been happening. In fact, when I talk to doctors' groups, when I ask doctors, if you gave patients the right care, not the care that's incentivized and so on, but you gave them the right care all the time, what would happen to their spending? The typical doctor says that spending would fall by about 25%.
Really, that's just doctors in aggregate?
Doctors, they'll say that just in aggregate for the patients they see, they're just getting way too much because the system is not set up to deal with them the right way.